In today's episode, we're gonna talk about ways of making your playback faster in Blender. I'm Luciano, and welcome to the adventures of LollypopMan. What's up, everyone? Today we have a tip to make your playback in Blender's viewport as fast as possible, so you don't have to create preview renders. We all know that in animation, being able to watch our shot in real time, it's key to working faster, because that's the biggest bottleneck when you're working in your animation. So remember to like and subscribe, and let's get on it. This episode is sponsored by me. Use the code below to get 10% discount on any of my products. We have here a sample scene. This is a shot of a sequence I did during my time at Pepeland.
Why do you have to be so bad? Why can't you be more like a good guy?
As you can see, if I press play in like render resolution, it can barely play. So I'm going to stop this and I'm going to try to make it as playable as possible. So the first thing that you want to do is use simplify. With simplify, by default starts in 6 subdivisions, so you just have to turn it down to 0. That should be a default. Like, it doesn't make any sense that you want to keep it still at the maximum subdivisions. And also, as you can see, because these really nice characters that the guys created at the Blender Animation Studio have hair and everything, taking that down to the minimum will also help a lot. I'll turn down the volume blah blah thing. But I don't know what it is. Volume resolution, I guess. Yeah, volume resolution. And that will already make an impact. As you can see, we went from not being able to play to something like 7 frames per second. And that it's a big difference, right? So now that we have something that we can more or less see, we should dive a little bit deeper. And so the second thing is, this will depend on your pipeline, your characters, whatever. Basically, if you make sure you have a low res version of each character, so I turn off that agent high. I actually had high and low at the same time. Let's see how it works only with the high res ones. So high res ones showing it's 8 frames per second, and before it was like 7. So yeah, there we go. And so if you turn off the high res ones and then turn on, in this case, the low res ones, then you should get an impact, and now we're getting to 10 frames per second. And so at this point, we're a little bit stuck because, well, they're in the lowest res. What can we do? Now it's where you start hiding stuff. And I have my scene organized with some collections. And basically, if I'm going to focus mainly on Boris in this case, because I want to polish him, then I can just turn off the other characters, and you can see we quickly go up to 20 frames per second, right? And so that means that the more stuff I turn off, the better for my performance. Like, we're getting there, and I think maybe I can put these two things also in that scene. Maybe I hit one that I shouldn't have. Where is my knife? Knife. Ah, here in scene. So maybe I don't want to have the knife in the scene. I'll have it as a separate thing. And the blood should be gone. Yeah, that should be gone. This guy should be gone. And then this armature is, what is this armature? No idea what it is. Oh yeah, it should be the armature for the knife. Interestingly enough, they're separate. So we're gonna make a collection for the knife with M, new collection, knife. Right, so we make sure we can turn it on and off easily if we need it or not. And yeah, now we're getting close to 22 frames, almost there. And that's all we can do, right? At least this gets you close enough so you can do most of your work. And then when you just need to watch it 100% accurate, you create a viewport render animation. And that's it. So yeah, that's basically the options you have. So even if we didn't get to 24 frames per second, mainly because these characters are very, very heavy, they're very well done, they're like feature quality characters, and so they have lots of details and the deformation is complex and stuff like that, so not possible to get there. Maybe if I had a faster computer, it should work. I'm using a regular home PC, so nothing out of the ordinary. But in a studio, you would probably have a much more powerful machine than what I have. If you have any other tips to add, definitely let me know. Remember to like and subscribe, and see me next time.